Hello there, good morning. You're watching Proactive London. Lisa Anson is joining us today, the CEO of Redx Pharma, a biotech company focused on the discovery and development of novel targeted medicines for the treatment of cancer and fibrotic diseases. A warm welcome to you, Lisa. So it certainly sounds like Redx is making progress. We're going to talk about all of that and more. So maybe just initially, to kickstart this conversation, take us through some of the recent highlights, if you would, Lisa.
Yeah, great to see you and very happy to. Yeah, Redx has been making really good progress this year, building on the transactions and the financing that we did last year. We've been very focused on moving our pipeline forward, and particularly the clinical pipeline, I think, is where the real progress has been made. So we have obviously continued our phase one program, so the early stage program for our lead oncology asset, which is called RXC004, and that's now completing. And we're expecting to move into phase two, which is a very exciting milestone for the company. The first time we've gone into phase two with a wholly owned asset of ours, and we're expecting to do that in the remainder of this year based on the good progress we've made. So that's the first program. And then hot on the heels behind that, we now have a second clinical program. So it's the first time again that Redx has had two clinical programs. And this is known as RXC007, and that's just gone into the clinic in the first half of the year. So really good progress on both of our lead programs.
Excellent. Tell us about some of the collaborations that you've had with large pharma companies and the progress that you're making with those collaborations, if you would.
Yeah, so I think we have done two major collaborations. We have one with Jazz Pharmaceuticals, which is an oncology, and that is a preclinical program, and that is progressing really well. And then we have a second program that we licensed to AstraZeneca, and that's for a porcupine inhibitor that's actually in fibrosis. Yeah. So one in oncology, one in fibrosis. The AstraZeneca one was signed last year, and we'd recently announced a milestone payment for that, which shows it's making really good progress towards the clinic. I would expect that to make it to the clinic. Obviously, it's AstraZeneca's asset, so that's their timeline and their decision. Mm-hmm. But as it continues to be in development, that's really good news. So both of them are in good hands. Both are moving forward really well. And I think it just underlines, actually, the fact that this company, Redx, has delivered now three molecules into the clinic, two I just talked about with us, one with Loxo, Lilly, now Lilly, which was a lead asset that we did partner. And then these two partnered assets, which are very close to the clinic. So it's close to saying that Redx has delivered five molecules to the clinic, which is a really tremendous track record for any company of our size.
Much achieved so far, as you've spoken about, Lisa, but what's to come in regards to 2021 and beyond? Do we have any particular inflection points for us?
Yeah, so we're very excited about the ESMO Congress, firstly, in September, where we're going to be presenting the full data set from our phase one study in monotherapy. Yeah. So that's a data presentation that we're looking forward to. And then, as I mentioned, on the back of those results, we have selected a dose to go forward into phase two. So we've announced that we've selected a 2 milligram dose. So we will be looking to start the phase two program in monotherapy. So that's the first thing to look out for, the data presentation and the start of the phase two. And then we'll also we're undertaking a second arm of the phase one in combination. So 004 in combination with nivolumab. Now we obviously, we've done the first cohort of that. We need to wait for a dose from that, and then we can start the combination phase two. So that's the next thing to look out for with 004. We would expect that to happen through the end of this year and early next year. And then with 007, we want to complete the healthy volunteer phase one study, and we'll present results in the first half of next year. So really busy program for the portfolio over the next 12 months. And at the same time, you know, I haven't talked here about the many discovery programs we have in our early stage research. It's less easy to put hard timelines on those. Mm-hmm. But what we have said is we're investing heavily in new molecules through our discovery engine, our proven teamwork and that our team that has been able to deliver all these molecules, and we've set a target of 3 new INDs, investigational new drugs, by 2025. So obviously, we will update as we have news on those, but that's what we're aspiring to deliver.
Clear goals and a packed agenda for you. In regards to the investment case for the company, why should investors look at Redx now?
Absolutely. I mean, I think now is a really great time for investors to look at us, because we have proven that we can do partnering deals and create value. We have proven that we have attracted specialist healthcare investors with Redmile and Sofinova and Polar, all of which we did last year, along with the deals with AstraZeneca and Jazz. We've proven we've got the ability to design great molecules with what's going forward with Lilly, Loxo Lilly molecule, but also our own 2 programs now in the clinic. And I think the company is in a much more stable position financially. We have a really great team that's in place, very well motivated. And so I think now is a key inflection point for us, because we're in the clinic, we've shown the track record, and we've got a packed program of data to come out over the next 12 months. So I think now is a really great time to join our specialist investors and invest in the company.
Lisa Anson, thank you very much indeed. Delivering your investment case, your progress there, and plenty more as well as deals with the likes of AstraZeneca and Jazz here on Proactive London, is the CEO of Redx Pharma.
Great, thank you.